Jose Benavidez Sr., we have the champ here. David, you got such a great reception yesterday. WBC Convention, he said the crowd went crazy for you. Tell me about that.
It was
because not every champ got cheers. I don't know if you guys noticed.
It was a cool experience, man. You know, everywhere I've been going, I've been getting a lot of love from the fans. You know, I take my time out, take pictures with them. I think that's what they really like. You know, they want to really feel in touch with the fighters. So, you know, I'm just very blessed to get all this reception from the fans and all the people that support me.
I told your dad, a lot of people here in Mexico are telling me they want to see you and Canelo mix it up.
Yeah.
Have you heard that yet?
Hopefully, you know, hopefully in the future we can get that fight. You know, I feel like if I keep doing what I'm doing, you know, putting up these great fights, becoming a household name, that will be a mega fight in the future.
Today is Deontay Wilder's birthday. What do you guys wish him?
Happy birthday, champion. I hope you have a great day, a blessed day, you know, and I can't wait to see his fight in November.
Yep. What do you tell Wilder?
Champ. I thought he was here in Cancun. I seen some pictures.
He has a fight in 4 days, so. Oh. I mean, not 4 days, November 23rd, right?
Three weeks.
Oh, yeah, so it's hard to break it.
I don't know why I thought he was here, but happy birthday, champ.
Henry Cejudo, I interviewed him. He was telling me that you had a big influence. Tell me about working with Henry.
Well, you know, after he came out from the Olympics, you know, I had the opportunity to be with him and go places with him. I was working with him for almost 2 years.
He's a funny dude.
Yeah, yeah.
Good sense of humor.
I mean, that guy, man, you know, that's the first time I seen somebody work really hard. That guy's like a machine, you know. He just gets sewn in and work really hard. And like I said, you know, that was the first time I seen somebody work at the next level, you know. But of course, he was an Olympian, you know. That's why he got the gold medal. But yeah, you know, he's a very hard worker, where he's at now because of hard work. And you know, the sky's the limit for this guy. You know, he's doing really good, and I wish him nothing but the best. And I think he's one of the most exciting fighters in the UFC right now.
So let me ask you about Triple C. What do you remember sparring him? You were 11 years old.
Yeah.
You were the same height. You grew. He didn't.
Yeah.
He has the exact same personality like Brandon Rios.
No, he's a funny dude.
You know, that's what I'm saying, like in a good way.
Yeah, he's a very cool dude. The thing about him, and he knows too, is when he used to work with my brother at Brian Davis, he knows exactly what I'm talking about too, man. That's what my dad's talking about, you know, working at the next level. That dude's just an animal, man.
Your brother back then was number one in the nation.
I remember sparring him back then, and we used to get into it because my dad used to be watching the spar, and he'd be trying to beat me up in front of my dad. So we had some good sparring sessions. Yeah.
What do you tell him now? Triple C. He's one of the biggest names.
He's one of my favorite fighters in the UFC right now, man. He's just a beast, and I think he's gonna become. He definitely is pound for pound already. I think he's gonna be the one of the best in the UFC in UFC history in the future.
What I like about him, not everybody could be a Klitschko. Not everybody could be 6'9". Not everybody could be a Shaquille O'Neal. But he's like a regular person, you know, he's like, what? I don't know his height, I don't want to be offensive, but people could relate that he's inspiring. You could be a superstar athlete and not have to be.
Yeah, and he's just a beast, man. You could just tell, you know, it's all hard work and dedication with him. He's just a beast, man.
I asked your dad, but let me ask you, November 2nd, Canelo Kovalev, your prediction?
I have to go with Canelo, man. I don't know. I don't feel like it's going to be a knockout. You know, I feel like both men are probably going to get hurt. But I think they're going to both dish it out. But I think Canelo's going to end up with the victory.
Let's start walking that way. Just walk around. But David, so you just fought and won. No injuries. You're clean. You're healthy. What's the next step? Your dad told me you're very close to signing something.
Yeah, I got a fight coming up. Maybe by the end of January, beginning of February. I don't know where it's going to be at. I'm hearing it's a big card. So I'm very excited. I don't know where it's gonna be at yet, but you know, just stay tuned, the fans. You know, I want to give the fans another great fight. I think I'm fighting the number one contender was the name Ildrim. So he's a great fighter too.
He's hungry and he wants you have.
And he puts a lot of good pressure on, you know, and he's all those guys that train out of Big Bear, they're all animals, you know what I mean? So I'm just looking to have another great fight.
Now, the fight with Caleb Plant is a fight everyone wants to see. There's bad blood. The beef is real.
Yeah.
What do you got? When will that happen? Sometime next year, maybe?
I don't know, but when it happens, I'm gonna end up beating his ass. You know.
Loma in the house, David. How you doing? Good morning.
Yeah. But hello, you know, hello. It's a good fight. You know, this is what we wanted. You know, the fans are excited about it. You know, the boxing, the people in the boxing world are excited about it. You know, we could have a world class fight. But, you know, but I'm gonna take his belt for sure.
Now, who would you want to see Pacquiao fight next? What would be exciting for you? Is it Mikey? Is it Sean Porter? Is it Spence? Is it Crawford?
I would love to see him fight Spence, you know, but ultimately what happened to Spence, you know, my prayers go out to him, you know, thank God nothing happened. But obviously I don't want to see him fight Spence, Garcia, and all of them. You know, whoever Manny Pacquiao fights right now is a great fighter. You know, Manny Pacquiao is just a great fighter, and he always comes to win.
So let me ask you guys this really quick. So, Errol Spence was in a bad car accident. Thank God he's okay. Yeah. What was your guys' reaction to that?
It was just crazy, man. Anything could be taken away, you know, in just a second. You know, I'm very glad, you know, I'm very glad to see that nothing bad happened to him and he didn't get no broken bones or none of that. But, you know, it just, we got to be a little bit more careful, man. I don't want to see anything happen to Errol Spence because he's one of my favorite fighters right now, too, you know.
And, he's a great dude.
It would be a big hit for boxing if something happened to him, you know. So we want him to stay healthy.
Jose, what did you think?
Well, you know, as soon as I saw that news, man, I was like, oh, wow, you know, it could be one of my sons or something like that. You know, I got worried, but thank God, you know, I don't know if it was good or bad that, you know, he came out flying, you know, he didn't have the seatbelt. But I think he's going to come strong. He's going to be ready to fight again. I heard that no broken bones or whatever. So that's really good, you know, and I'm happy for him. And hopefully that show us a lesson, you know, to all of us and all the fighters, you know, that, please, you know, whenever you drink, you know, get an Uber, you know, right now Uber or whatever, you know.
Spence Crawford,
I would have to go with, it's going to be a tough fight, man. It's a tough fight, a very exciting fight. That's what we want to see, but I, 50-50, man, but I'm going to go towards Spence a little bit.
Well, I got Spence too, you know what I mean? Crawford be my brother, so I want to see Crawford get beat, but, you know, no bad blood there, but it's going to be a great fight. You know, obviously you got Crawford. He's just a technician. He uses the ring very well, you know. And then Errol Spence, you know, is a pressure fighter, you know, throws some great body shots. So I feel like it'll be a great fight, but I'm leaning towards Spence.
There was a fight about a week ago, Bitterbayev against Bozdik.
I've seen that, yeah.
Did you see the response of people saying, we want to see David fight this guy?
It was a crazy fight, man.
The guy's a beast.
I sparred Alexander, you know, so he's a great fighter too, but I think Bitterbayev is just on a different level, man. He has some amazing power, and he's just relentless with that pressure. You know what I mean? It's not one punch knockout power, but he's just there all night. You know, and that guy doesn't get tired, so he's a great fighter. Hats off to him. Congratulations.
You think Bivol can take him?
I feel like all those guys, you know, they all have similar style because they're just so powerful. You know what I mean? But I think Bivol's a little bit more technical than Alexander, so.
That would be a great fight.
You sparred Bivol. I was there.
Yeah.
So you sparred two out of the three.
Yeah.
How hard does Bozdik hit? Because I was always told that he hits very hard.
The thing about him is he doesn't hit too hard. I didn't feel like he hit too hard. He was just very accurate. You know what I mean? And then he's just trying to set you off with that 1-2. I feel like Bivol is the same way, but Bivol hits a little bit harder than Bozdik.
David, I have to ask. You are here for the WBC convention. You have that belt back in your hand. How does it feel to come to the convention knowing that belt, it's your baby?
Yeah, it feels amazing. You know, it feels more amazing that everything I said I was gonna do, I made happen. I said I was gonna stop Anthony Durrell, and I stopped Anthony Durrell. So now I'm just kind of relaxing, having a good time before I gotta go back into training camp. And then, you know, I got some big news coming soon. We're gonna have a big fight. Probably gonna be on a big undercard too, so I'm very excited.
Oh, I thought you were gonna fight Canelo next.
No.
It was crazy, you're only 22, that's the scary.
Yeah.
Only 22, I mean, you have 10 more years at least in this sport.
Yeah, I'm excited, man. I turned 23 this December, so 23 is basically 26. So.
All right, last thing. Tank Gamboa, they're gonna fight in December.
Yeah. It's gonna be a good fight too. Obviously, Gervonta Davis is one of the best fighters right now. Very exciting fighter. Gamboa back then, he was a very exciting fighter too, but I feel like Gervonta Davis is gonna make a big splash. Are they fighting up at 135 or
135? And last thing, Jose, for you to come here as a trainer of champions, you've made three champions, Zlatanin, Jose, and David, of course. What's it mean to you to be here at the convention?
It's a dream come true, man. I never thought I would be here with all these people, you know, nothing but legends here, man. I get chills, you know, because I didn't know nothing about boxing. I never even thought about being here. And look at me, I'm here. So if I could do it, anybody could do it. If you just put your mind into it, the time and dedication, anything can happen, you know? Sky's the limit, man. And I'm grateful to the WBC for that recognition, you know, with the WBC belt. And I'm thankful with all the people, all the fans, and everybody that's supporting us.
Okay, my last question. What's the worst injury your son gave you in training? Did he break a bone, a black and blue mark, a dislocated shoulder, or nothing?
Nothing, man.
You're
so
lucky.
So far, so good.
You take it easy on your dad?
Sometimes.
You know, I try to buy those big mitts. I try to buy those protectors that are like...
You were wearing two body shields when I was there.
Yeah. So I gotta make sure I protect myself, man. You know me, I'm skinny, small.
No, because he can hit hard. He's a big puncher. Yeah.
I'm a little guy, man. He's a 168-pounder, man. Super middleweight, man. I mean, I'm little.
Well, thank you so much for all the interviews and all the time. Proud of you. You're doing great. Tell everybody where to follow you.
Follow me at Benavidez 300. Also, you can get some of my merchandise, my shirts at davidbenavidez.shop. Also, my dad has his line at home.
davidbenavidez.shop. Yeah, and where do they go for you?
Jose Benavidez Senior, Instagram, Facebook, all social media.
All right, there you have it. Stay tuned. Peace reporting. Come and take back reporting. Listen, send me a